Okay, let us see now the throttling calorimeter. So see, throttling calorimeter is using the process of throttling. What is mean by throttling? Throttling manje kay? Apan baghitle. What is mean by throttling? Throttling is the process due to which we are reducing the pressure passing the high pressure gases through restricted area. That is called as a throttling. Okay, means we will pass it through the restricted area so that the pressure is reduced on another side. That is called as a throttling process. So I have given the example that if you are having the tube, air tube vehicle ji air tube jar asel and ti puncture zali tar kay zalo, on one side you will have very high pressure and on another side it is very low pressure. So air pressure is reduced by passing through the small hole. That is called as a throttling process. Similarly, when you pass the steam through the walls or water through the walls also. See, water sudha apan javes paniche tank aste eka side la tap cha, tar tya tap cha eka side la pressure khup jast asto, te mhanje tank cha pressure asto, ani dusrya side la kay asto tar atmospheric pressure asto. So when you open the tap, the pressure of that water will becomes atmospheric pressure. So that is again throttling process. So walls, taps, hole, these are the we can say that orifice. These are the small restricted area through which you can pass the fluid so that the pressure is going to reduce. So it is a pressure reducing process. That is called as a throttling process. Now during this throttling process, we can see that there is no work done, there is no heat supply or rejection. Heat supply kiwa rejection nahi hai, kiwa work done pan hot nahi. Ani velocity change is also not that much. Okay, velocity change is also not that much because on one side also the area steam is at steady condition and another side also atmospheric condition, so steady condition. So velocity change is also not that much. So these type of the processes are considered as the isenthalpic process. That is, enthalpy of the fluid will remains constant during this process. That is called as a isenthalpic process. Enthalpy during throttling process is remains constant. That is called as a isenthalpic process. We have seen it in the first unit when we have studied the steady flow energy equation or the first law energy equation for the steady flow processes. So in during that we have seen that the throttling process is nothing but isenthalpic process. Enthalpy before throttling and enthalpy after throttling remains constant. Why it is remaining constant? That also I have explained now, that we are not doing any work, we are not having the heat supply or heat rejection, as well as we are not changing much kinetic energy or potential energy. So only change, or we can say that the enthalpy will remain same, only the pressure is changing, and due to that the internal energy may vary. So due to which we can say that the enthalpy will remain same. So that is called as a isenthalpic process. So see, this throttling process is used to measure the dryness fraction, and that is called as a throttling calorimeter. So we are using the throttling process for measurement of dryness fraction in throttling calorimeter. So here we are having, see, this is a diagram of the calorimeter, we can say that. So steam main is there, means main pipe is there through which the steam is going. Through that main pipe you will take sample of the steam of which you want to measure the dryness fraction. This is a dryness fraction measure karte the steam ikade ghetli. We will measure the pressure of that steam, that is P1, before throttling. We will measure the pressure before throttling. Now there is a throttling wall. Wall is there, that is actually the throttling wall. We can throttle it through this wall, or orifice you can use. Orifice manje kay? Ki ek disc aste and that disc la ek chota sa hole kelela asta. So we will have one disc, and on that disc small diameter hole is there. That is called as a orifice. Okay, so that type of orifice you can connect there, or you can have the throttling wall here. So if you open the wall, there will be restricted area through which the steam will pass. So on one side you will have the pressure P1, and on another side you will have the less pressure. You will have the less pressure on another side. See, on one side you will have the pressure P1, and on another side of that wall you will have the pressure P2. On another side you will have the pressure P2, and you want to measure the temperature after throttling also. So T2 temperature is there, P2 pressure is there after throttling, P1 pressure is before throttling, T1 temperature also you can measure, or that is equal to the saturation temperature of steam. So these three readings are required. That is the only three readings are required for measurement of the dynaspection. Now after this you can pass this steam through the condenser, that is called as a cooling water. You can supply and you can condense that steam. You can measure the mass of the steam also. There is no problem, but we are not using it for this experiment. We will use it for the next experiment. So this experiment is requiring only the three readings. What is that? The pressure before throttling, pressure after throttling, and temperature after throttling. So these are the readings only required for this experiment. Okay, so let us see what is going to happen due to the throttling process. So see, you can see here. Now let us consider that. See, in the morning's lecture, sakalcha lecture la apan shiklo ki this is a HS plot, that is a molar diagram. So in molar diagram, this dark line is showing you the saturation line. Dark line is showing you the saturation line, while this P1 is the pressure line, P2 is another pressure line, and temperature line is like this. Temperature line is like this. Okay, so P1 is the higher pressure line, that is 10 bar, while the P2 is the lower pressure line, 1.2 bar. 1.2 bar is just near to the atmosphere. Okay, 1.2 bar is just near to the atmosphere. So that is the final temperature, and initial temperature is 10 bar, which is very high. So let us consider that the dynaspection of the steam which is coming out of the boiler, or we want to measure, is x1. So we can mark that point by combining it, the pressure line P1 and dynaspection line like this. So the one point will be this, means before throttling you will have the condition at point 1. Are you getting this point? Are you getting this point or not? See, x1 is the dynaspection of the steam and P1 is the pressure, then the point 1 is indicating you the initial conditions of the steam, that is before throttling. Before throttling the condition of the steam is this. But when you reduce the pressure due to the throttling process, जर आपण throttling process केली तर त्याचं pressure कमी होईल. आता ते प्रेशर किती पर्यंत कमी करायचं, तर दॅट यू कॅन रिड्यूस अप टू द ऍटमॉस्फिरिक प्रेशर ऑल्सो. यू कॅन रिड्यूस इट अप टू ऍटमॉस्फिरिक प्रेशर. नाव इन दिस केस दॅट प्रेशर इज रिड्यूस अप टू 1.2 bar. सो द प्रेशर इज रिड्यूस अप टू 1.2 bar. नाव ॲज दिस इज अ आयसेंथाल्पिक प्रोसेस. दिस इज अ आयसेंथाल्पिक प्रोसेस मीन्स वॉट? द एन्थाल्पी ॲट पॉइंट एच वन इज इक्वल टू एन्थाल्पी ॲट पॉइंट टू एच टू, because that is a horizontal line. So if you draw the horizontal line from 1 and it is intersecting to the pressure P2, then you can see that the point 2 you can get. Point 2 you will get by drawing horizontal line from 1 and the pressure line 1.2. So point 2 you will get here. So what you can see? This is a isenthalpic process. So what you can see? The point 2 is lying in this region. What is this region? This is one region, this is another region, and this is third region. So steam is in this region first, that is a wet region. We are saying that wet steam is here, and before that we are having the liquid region. Now what about this region? Which region it is? Yes, can you tell me? Anyone can tell what is that region? What is the condition of the steam? Yes, we have seen the 5 points. One is liquid, second is dry saturated, third is wet, the fourth is dry saturated vapors and dry saturated liquid, and fifth is there superheated. So out of that 5 points, what is the point 2 is indicating? Yes, can anyone tell? व्हाट इज दॅट पॉईंट टू इज इंडिकेटिंग, विच रिजन इट इज. यस,
ड्राय सॅच्युरेटेड.
ही ड्राय सॅच्युरेटेड मीन्स व्हॉट? दॅट इज ऑन द सॅच्युरेटेड लाईन. आर यू इन दिस पॉइंट? ड्राय सॅच्युरेटेड मीन्स जी पॉइंट. सो जी पॉइंट इज नॉट देअर, इट इज अबाउट जी पॉइंट. मीन्स विच पॉइंट? इट इज अ सुपर हीटेड रिजन. रिमेंबर दॅट इट इज नॉट ड्राय सॅच्युरेटेड, इट इज अ सुपर हीटेड. सो यू विल गेट द सुपर हीटेड स्टीम. रिमेंबर दॅट यू विल गेट द सुपर हीटेड स्टीम. So this is the point two. Okay, let us see that so that you will be more clear about this. So in this case, there are five points I have said: A, F, B, G, and C. So this is TS diagram actually. The initial condition is B, and final condition is above this line. Above this line. So that is applying. In this region, that is superheated region. So the steam condition after throttling will becomes the superheated. So you can say that it is superheated steam you will get after the throttling process. Okay. So after throttling process, you will have the superheated steam. That is the thing that is going to happen. Okay. So see, one thing I want to tell you that is interesting thing here. Suppose I am having the steam whose temperature is near about 110. Is it a superheated steam or dry saturated steam, or it is a wet water? What do you think? Give me the answer. I am having H2O. H2O is there with me, whose temperature is near about 110 degrees centigrade. So what should be the condition of that H2O? It should be water, or it should be a dry saturated steam, or wet steam, or it may be a superheated steam. So what should be the condition? What do you think? Can you tell me the answer for this question? जर 109 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेडला माझ्याकडे H2O आहे तर त्याची कंडिशन काय असेल? पाणी असेल, वाफ असेल, का सुपरहीटेड स्टीम असेल? हा सिंपल क्वेश्चन विचारला मी तुम्हाला. व्हॉट डू यू थिंक? ओके, सो यू आर सेइंग दॅट सुपरहीटेड स्टीम. सी, यू कांट गिव द आन्सर, दॅट्स वाय आय हॅव टेलिंग लाईक दिस, दॅट इट इज नॉट द करेक्ट आन्सर. सी, सुपरहीटेड स्टीम विल बी देअर इफ द प्रेशर इज ऍटमॉस्फिरिक. इफ आय से दॅट प्रेशर इज 10 bar, देन I am having the H2O whose temperature is 110 degree centigrade, but pressure is 10 bar. Then what is the condition of that H2O? It is water. Yes or no? ते पाणी असेल ना. जर 10 bar pressure असेल त्याच तर ते पाणी असेल, कारण 10 bar प्रेशरला 180 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेड टेम्परेचर होईपर्यंत त्याची वाफ होणार नाही. 180 टेम्परेचरच्या पुढेच वाफ असेल, वाफ असेल 180 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेड टेम्परेचरला. 110 असेल तर ते पाणीच असेल. सो दॅट विल डिपेंड अपॉन द प्रेशर. इट इज नॉट ओनली डिपेंड अपॉन द टेम्परेचर. प्रेशर आणि टेम्परेचर दोन्ही कंडिशन्स महत्वाचे आहेत. तर एकच कंडिशन महत्वाची नाही आहे. रिमेंबर दिस थिंग, प्रेशर ॲज वेल ॲज टेम्परेचर. इफ यू आर हॅविंग द हायर प्रेशर्स, देन इट विल रिक्वायर द हायर टेम्परेचर फॉर द सॅच्युरेशन. इफ यू आर हॅविंग द लोअर टेम्परेचर्स, then it will require the lower temperatures for saturation. Now in this case, what do you think? The steam is becoming from wet to superheated. Ita kay hota ki wet pasun superheated steam bante, par ya case madhe apan tyacha temperature vadhatoy ka? Apan tyacha temperature vadvat nahiye. We are not increasing the temperature, we are not heating it. What we are doing? We are reducing the pressure. We are reducing to it up to 1.2 bar. आर रीड दिस पॉइंट. समजते काय म्हणतो ते. आता मग अशी जर परत एक्झाम्पल घेऊया की 10 bar प्रेशरला जर 180 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेडला किंवा 110 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेड घेतला, 110 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेड आहे H2O आणि 10 bar प्रेशर आहे, तर ते पाणीच असणार आहे. पण त्याच जागी जर मी त्याला प्रेशर कमी केलं आणि त्याचं प्रेशर केलं ऍटमॉस्फेरिक प्रेशर, त्यावेळेस तिथं काय असेल 110 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेडला, दॅट इज सुपर हिटेड स्टीम. आय एम नॉट हिटिंग ऍट ऑल, जस्ट आय एम रिड्युसिंग द प्रेशर. सो बाय रिड्युसिंग द प्रेशर ऑल्सो यू कॅन हॅव द सुपर हिटेड स्टीम. ओके, इट विल नॉट हॅव द एक्स्ट्रा एनर्जी. ओनली थिंग इज दॅट इट्स कन्वर्टेड इन टू द सुपर हिटेड स्टीम. सो दॅट यू शुड बी क्लिअर, because examiner will oral examination is there and during that it may ask the questions like this. So see, so let us go back to our practical. So we are having the one point is there, which is on the transfection line and the pressure, high pressure line 10 bar. So that is point 1. When you reduce the pressure, it goes to the point 2 where the pressure is 1.2 bar. And that is coming in the superheated region. Now, throttling process, we are considering that is isenthalpic process. Means what? The enthalpy at point 1 is equal to enthalpy at point 2. So, that is H1 is equal to H2. H1 is equal to H2. Now, see, the one point is according to us, it is a B point. While the two point is according to us, it is a C point. So, you can find out the enthalpy at H1. You can write it as HF1 plus XHFG1. Okay, but only thing is required is the pressure at point 1 that you are measuring with the pressure gauge. So P1 pressure bagaycha ani HF1 plus X1 HFG1. So this formula you can use. While H2 is what? H2 is in point C. C point la kaya hai H2? HG2 plus CP of the steam, superheated steam, into T superheated minus T saturated. See, T superheated and T saturated, that we are going to measure. T superheated upon T2 na measure karnar ahe, and T saturation we can find out it from the pressure P2. So this H2 can be found out at pressure P2 and this H1 can be found out at pressure P1. And you will find in this equation everything is known to us. Everything is known to us. Only X1 will becomes unknown quantity. So if you are knowing all the quantities and X1 you have to find out, you can find out that X1. So with this equation, you can find out the X1. Okay, so this is a simple method to find out the X1. That is enthalpy, isenthalpic process, throttling process. From that, you will get the dryness fraction of the steam. Is there any doubt? Is there any doubt? Is there any doubt? Okay, so now, see, if you are having the doubts, I can give the time, no problem. You can message also. So if you are not having the doubt, let us go to the next point. See, limitations of the throttling calorimeter. What are the limitations of the throttling calorimeter? So see, limitations of the throttling calorimeter. Now, I have considered that the 1 to 2 process first. In 1 to 2 process. So in that case, if I reduce the pressure, then it will comes to the superheated conditions. If I am considering that the initial condition is 2, then final condition will be 1. If I consider the initial condition as 2, then final condition will be 1. In that case, the dryness fraction is this much, that is 93.6. But if I reduce the dryness fraction, if I reduce the dryness fraction, and if well, I will have the lower dryness fraction. Apan jar lower dryness fraction ghetla, manje 0.95 ahe ite samja varcha line la, to jar mi 0.8 ghetla, tar te kay hoil ki line khali yeil, and due to which the 0.2 is shifted towards the 0.3. Pressure same hai, same pressure I am considering in first case and second case. So in second case the 0.3 will be here. Now if I reduce the pressure up to the similar pressure as that of the first one, then the point will be 4. The point will be 4. So what is going to happen? In first case, the steam becomes superheated because it is going in this region. So that will superheated. But in this case, the steam is not crossing this saturated line and it is remaining in the wet region only. It is remaining in the wet region only. So initial condition and final condition, both conditions are wet. In these conditions or for this एक्सपेरिमेंट व्हाट वी वांट द इनिशियल कंडीशन मस्ट बी वेट व्हाइल फाइनल कंडीशन मस्ट बी सुपर हीटेड देन एंड देन ओनली द थ्रॉटलिंग कैलोरीमीटर इज यूजफुल अदरवाइज द थ्रॉटलिंग कैलोरीमीटर दिस इक्वेशन इज नॉट यूजफुल कारण तिथं त्या केसमध्ये काय होईल एच एफ वन प्लस एक्स वन एच एफ जी वन इज इक्वल टू एच टू कसं कॅल्क्युलेट करणार एच एफ टू प्लस एक्स टू एच एफ जी टू आणि एक्स वन आणि एक्स टू दोन दोन जर तुम्हाला अननोन असतील तर तुम्हाला ते काढता येणार नाही इफ यू आर हॅव्हिंग द टू अननोन्स दॅट इज एक्स वन ऑन वन साईड अँड एक्स टू ऑन अदर साईड यू कॅन सॉल्व्ह दिस इक्वेशन सो व्हॉट वी रिक्वायर दॅट फायनल पॉईंट मस्ट बी इन द सुपर हिटेड रिजन फायनल पॉईंट मस्ट बी इन द सुपर हिटेड रिजन अँड दिस इज नॉट ऑकरिंग इन द सेकंड केस वाय इट इज नॉट ऑकरिंग बिकॉज वी हॅव कन्सिडर द लोअर ड्रायनेस फ्रॅक्शन we have considered the lower drainage fraction and that is the limitation of the throttling calorimeter limitations of the throttling calorimeter is that if the steam is very wet the resultant drainage fraction x cannot be obtained and it is inaccurate cannot be obtained as well as it is inaccurate you can say that it cannot be obtained also okay and so that the drainage fraction more than 0.85 then and then only the throttling calorimeter can be used if you are having the steam which is more dry then the throttling calorimeter is preferred generally when it is more than 0.85 so this is the use of the throttling calorimeter see separating calorimeter is used for the lower drainage fraction while throttling calorimeters are used for the higher drainage fraction okay and it is having the limitation that when wet steam is there you can't use the throttling calorimeter and separating calorimeter is there having the limitation when you go for the very dry steam the separation is become difficult so that is not used for the higher drainage fraction so both are having the limitation separating is having the limitation that it cannot be used for higher drainage fraction while throttling is having the limitation that it cannot be used for lower drainage fraction so both drawbacks can be avoided by combining these two calorimeters that is separating as well as throttling and that will be the fourth type of calorimeter separating and throttling calorimeter combined separating and throttling calorimeter okay so that we will see for the tomorrow's lecture now just see the problem that is there on the screen you can see in a throttling calorimeter the steam is admitted at 8 bar 10 bar so the pressure at point 1 is 10 bar it is throttled to the atmospheric pressure means what the pressure after throttling is atmospheric and its temperature is 110 degree centigrade its temperature is 110 degree centigrade now you can see initial pressure is 10 bar jar initial pressure 10 bar asel steam cha ani ti jar steam wet asel तर त्याचं टेम्परेचर किती असेल तर 180 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेड रिमेंबर दिस आपण स्टीम टेबल मधून तुम्ही बघू शकता स्टीम टेबल मधून बघू शकता की 10 बार प्रेशर असेल जर स्टीमचं तर त्या 10 बार प्रेशरला सॅच्युरेशन टेम्परेचर किती आहे तर सॅच्युरेशन टेम्परेचर 10 बार प्रेशरला हे 180 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेड आहे साधारण 180 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेड सो इफ यू आर हॅव्हिंग द 10 बार स्टीम which is sent to the calorimeter it is having the 180 degree centigrade temperature now when you pass through the throttling device throttling valve then its pressure is reduced where up to what level it is reducing to the atmospheric conditions means 1.013 bar and what it is pressure sorry temperature its temperature is also reduced it may goes to the 110 degree centigrade okay it is temperature it's become 110 degree centigrade now atmospheric condition and 110 degree centigrade temperature means the steam is becoming superheated in that case but have you observed one thing ek gosht lakshat ghetli ka tumcha ali ka ki initial condition la 180 degree centigrade hota ani tya veles wet steam hoti आपण ती थ्रोटल केल्यानंतर त्याचं टेम्परेचर कमी झालं आणि ती स्टीम सुपर हीटेड झाली लक्षात घ्या सी दिस इज द पॉइंट दॅट यू शुड अंडरस्टँड ट्राय टू अंडरस्टँड दिस पॉइंट की सुरुवातीची कंडिशन ही 180 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेडची होती 10 बार प्रेशरची त्यावेळेस स्टीम कसली होती वेट होती वेट स्टीम पण ज्यावेळेस तुम्ही तिचं प्रेशर कमी केलं आणि टेम्परेचर पण कमी झालं तरी पण स्टीम कशी झाली दॅट बिकम सुपर हिटेड. ओके, सो फॉर सुपर हिटिंग इट इज नॉट ओनली इन्क्रीजिंग द टेम्परेचर इज द पॉइंट, बट यू कॅन मेक इट बाय रिड्युसिंग द प्रेशर ऑल्सो. प्रेशर कमी केलं तरी स्टीम सुपर हिटेड होऊ शकते बिकॉज सॅच्युरेशन टेम्परेचर यू आर रिड्युसिंग. सो दॅट यू शुड अंडरस्टँड, ट्राय टू अंडरस्टँड दिस पॉइंट. ओके, सो डिटरमाइन द ड्रायनेस फ्रॅक्शन ऑफ द स्टीम, अज्यूम द स्पेसिफिक हीट ऑफ सुपर हिटेड स्टीम एज 2.2. यू कॅन कन्सिडर द स्पेसिफिक हीट फॉर द सुपर हिटेड स्टीम एज 2.2 ऑर 2.1. सो जस्ट हियर द इक्वेशन इज रिटन, एच एफ वन इज प्लस एच एक्स वन एच एफ जी वन इज इक्वल टू एच टू. सो यू कॅन राईट एक्स इज इक्वल टू एच एफ एच टू मायनस एच एफ वन डिवायडेड बाय एच एफ जी वन. एच टू कॅन बी कॅल्क्युलेटेड डायरेक्टली फ्रॉम द सुपर हिटेड स्टीम टेबल ऑर बाय युझिंग द इक्वेशन एच जी प्लस 2.2 दॅट इज सी पी डब्ल्यू टी सुपर हिटेड दॅट इज 110 मायनस टी एस दॅट इज 100 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेड इज द टी एस फॉर दिस प्रेशर. सो यू कॅन फाइंड आउट द ड्रायनेस फ्रॅक्शन ऑफ 0.96. सो दिस इज वॉट द मेजरमेंट ऑफ ड्रायनेस फ्रॅक्शन बाय थ्रोटलिंग कॅलरोमीटर. सो लाईक वाईज वी हॅव सीन द थ्री डिफरंट टाईप्स ऑफ द थ्रोटलिंग कॅलरोमीटर्स. वन इज बॅरल कॅलरोमीटर, सेकंड इज सेपरेटिंग कॅलरोमीटर अँड थर्ड इज थ्रोटलिंग कॅलरोमीटर. सो सेपरेटिंग इज हॅविंग वन ड्रॉबॅक, थ्रोटलिंग इज